Assalamu alaikum.
Walaikum
assalam. A day of a Muslim series. So after waking up from bed, from sleep during night, we may read a dhikr. We shall read one dhikr. That is Bismillahi. Yes. Apart from that, another dhikr is that La ilaha illallah wahdahu la sharika lah.
La ilaha illallah wahdahu la sharika lahu lahul mulku wa lahul hamdu yuhyi wa yumitu wa huwa ala kulli shay'in qadir. Alhamdulillahi wa subhanallahi wa la ilaha illallah wallahu akbar. La ilaha la quwwata illa billahi al-aliyyil azim.
La ilaha illallah wahdahu la sharika lah. Lahul mulku wa lahul hamd yuhyi wa yumitu wa huwa ala kulli shay'in qadir. Alhamdulillahi wa subhanallahi ولا اله الا الله والله اكبر ولا حول ولا قوه الا بالله العلي العظيم لا اله الا الله there is no ilah la ilaha there is no ilah none there is none deserves to be worshipped illa allah except allah wahdah he is the only one he is the only one la sharika lah
and has
no partners sharik partner له الملك and to him belongs dominion or power or kingdom وله الحمد and to him belongs all praises or all praises are due to him to Allah alone he gives life hayat ويميتو and he gives life and takes it وهو أن he is على كل شيء قدير he is omnipotent he is omnipotent he is powerful over all things means he is omnipotent all powerful then again alhamdulillah all praises are due to Allah all praises belongs to Allah وسبحانallah glory to Allah and glory to Allah wa la ilaha illallah and there is no ilah or none deserves to be worshipped except Allah wallahu akbar and Allah is the greatest wa la hawla wa la quwwata illa billahi al-aliyyil azim and there is no might or power except Allah al-aliyyil azim and he is the highest the magnificent now we shall see the proof from the hadith Hadith number 1154 of Sahih al-Bukhari. Under Kitab al-Tahajjud, Bab Fadli Man Ta'arra Min al-Layli Faswalla. Chapter. The one who wakes up at night and offers night prayer or Tahajjud prayer. Okay. Hadasana Sadaqat ibn al-Fadl. And the sanad goes. Then. حدثني عبادة بن الصامت عبادة بن الصامت عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم so narrated by عبادة بن الصامت a صحابي from the prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم قال he said that means Allah's messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم said من تعار من الليل whoever wakes up from sleep during night time and say فقال and then he say لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد وهو على كل شيء قدير الحمد لله وسبحان الله ولا إله إلا الله والله أكبر ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله then ثم قال then he said اللهم اغفر لي oh Allah اغفر لي you forgive my sins what أو دعاء or the prophet said like this دعاء استجيبا or the man After reciting the said dhikr, supplication, لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد and in some reports there is يحيي ويميت also له الملك وله الحمد and after that يحيي ويميت then وهو على كل شيء قدير الحمد لله وسبحان الله in some reports it is سبحان الله والحمد لله الحمد لله وسبحان الله ولا إله إلا الله والله أكبر ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله then in some reports it is addition, Al-Aliyyil Azim also is there. Al-Aliyyil Azim. Then, so after reading this dhikr, if any person pray to Allah, da'a, invoke Allah, then ustujiba, he will be answered. His call, his invocation will be surely answered. What the Prophet said? Allahumma ghafirli. If the person say Allahumma ghafirli, he will be forgiven. Then, فَإِن تَوَلَّأَ وَصَلَّى قُبِلَتْ صَلَاتُهُ. And after that, if he performs ablution or wudu, then performs salah, then his prayer, his salah will be accepted. قُبِلَتْ accepted. Will be accepted. Now, the sharah. So, in the sharah, the last part we see. In one report we see, ثُمَّ قَالَ رَبِّ اغْفِرْ لِي غِفِرَ لَهُ أَوْ قَالَ فَدْعَى أُسْتُجِيبَ لَهُ. In one report it is like that. After reading this particular supplication or dhikr, then if the person say, رَبِّ اغْفِرْ لِي. So in another report it is, اللَّهُمَّ اغْفِرْ لِي. اللَّهُمَّ O Allah, اغْفِرْ لِي, you forgive me. Here it is, رَبِّ اغْفِرْ لِي. O Lord, O Rabb, اغْفِرْ لِي, you forgive me. غُفِرَ لَهُ. Then he will be forgiven. Then, أو قال, or the Prophet said like this, فدعا استجيب له. He, if he invoke Allah, فاستجيب له, then he will be answered. His prayer, his invocation will be answered. Then, now, قوله, فإن تولى قبلت. In some reports, فإن تولى, then if he performs ablution, قُبِلَتْ, it will be accepted. So it means that فَإِن تَوَلَّى وَصَّلَّى قُبِلَتْ. Because in some reports it is like that. فَإِن تَوَلَّى وَصَّلَّى قُبِلَتْ. If he performs wudu, then performs salah, then it will be accepted from him. Then. Now, قَالَ بِنُ بَطْوَالْ وَعَدَ اللَّهُ عَلَى لِسَانِ نَبِيِّهِ أن من استيقظ من نومه لهجن لسانه بتوحيد ربه والإذعان له بالملك والاعتراف بنعمه يحمده عليها وينزهه عما لا يليق به بتسبيحه والخضوع له بالتكبير والتسليم له بالعجز عن القدرة إلا بعونه أنه إذا دعا أجابه وإذا صلى قبلت صلاته فينبغي لمن بلغه هذا الحديث أن يغتنم العمل به ويخلص نيته لربه سبحانه وتعالى. Now Ibn Battal says about this hadith. He remarks, وعد الله على لسان نبيه. وعد الله. Allah has promised على لسان نبيه through the tongue of the Holy Prophet, of our Holy Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, of his Prophet, that is Allah's Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Anna man istayqadha min nawmihi. Whoever wakes up from his sleep during night time. Lahajan lisanahu. That is, with his tongue, through, that is, making his tongue live with the dhikr or remembrance of Allah. So, when whoever wakes up from sleep, from his bed, lahajan lisanahu. That is, making live his tongue with the remembrance of Allah. That is, with the dhikr of Allah. So, in his lisan, in his tongue, the remembrance, the dhikr of Allah is there. Then, in such a condition, then, with tawheed rabbihi, with what dhikr? That is, the tawheed, the oneness of Allah. Then, وَالْإِذْعَانَ لَهُ بِالْمُلْكِ, and submitting to Allah before his sovereignty or power or kingdom, dominion. Then, وَالْإِعْتِرَافِ بِنِعْمِهِ, and recognizing all the favors Allah has bestowed upon the person, upon him. Then, لا يليق, وَيَحْمَدُهُ عَلَيْهَا and praising Allah upon those favors which he had bestowed upon that person. Then وَلِعْتِرَافِ بِنِعْمِهِ يَحْمَدُهُ عَلَيْهَا وَيَنَزِّهُهُ عَمَّا لَا يَلِيقُ بِتَسْبِيحِهِ and glorifying Allah above all. None is equal to Allah. So none will be equal to Allah. So glorifying Allah above all, above everything, above all powers. Then وَالْخُضُعِ لَهُ بِالتَّكْبِيرِ and surrendering to Allah with the takbir, Allahu Akbar, Allah is the greatest, surrendering before Allah. Allah is the greatest. So we have to surrender before Him. وَالتَّسْلِيمِ لَهُ بِالْعَجْزِ and His inability, the person, the slave's inability, he recognizes. عَلِي الْقُدْرَةِ إِلَّا بِعَوْنِهِ so His ability will be only according to the that which is conferred by Allah to him. So except by the help of Allah, without the help of Allah, he has no power at all, no ability at all. The slave has no ability, no power at all. Okay, so and recognizing all these things, annahu idha da'ahu, then so confirming all these things in his mind or bringing all these things in his mind, then if he supplicate to Allah or if he invoke Allah, ajabahu, his invocation or prayer will be answered. وَإِذَا صَلَّى and if he performs salah, قُبِلَتْ صَلَاتُهُ his prayer, salah, will be accepted. فَيَنْبَغِي then it will be necessary, it is necessary, it is unavoidable, it is wajib or it is compulsory, obligatory. لِمَنْ بَلَغَهُ هَذَا الْحَدِيثِ who had come to touch with this hadith or who has got this hadith, for him it is necessary. What? So for you this hadith you got now. Okay, from me I have given you this hadith. Okay, so you can say my father or our father hasn't taught us this hadith, so that's why we neglected it. You can't say like that. Okay, no excuse. So فَيَنْبَغِي لِمَنْ بَلَغَهُ هَذَا الْحَدِيثِ so it is necessary for anyone who got this hadith. What? أَنْ يَغْتَنِمَ الْعَمَلَ بِهِ to act upon this hadith. That is to act upon, to act according to this hadith. وَيَخْلِصُ نِيَّتَهُ لِرَبِّهِ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى that is making his niyat towards his Rabb subhanahu wa ta'ala with ikhlas, so with sincerity to Allah, then so it is necessary, it is mandatory, it is unavoidable. Okay, then assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum.